One of the most important productivity methods I use for law school is the ABCDE method, as described and explained by Brian Tracy in his book, Eat That Frog. The premise of the book is simple. Our most difficult tasks ought to be scheduled as our first activity for the day. Every other task on our to-do lists becomes easier. Today, I'll be showing you how the ABCDE method works and how I am using it to meet all of my productivity goals in law school. I'll also be showing you the detailed steps and examples on how to achieve all of your daily tasks in law school. All of this and more coming right up! This episode is brought to you by the Lex in Motion merch store, where the perks and perils of being a law student through graphic tees and statement shirts help us help others more now and in the future. Even better, make a direct donation to the charities we support. Both links in the description below. Hi, my name is Lex and welcome to Lex in Motion. In this channel, I'll be helping you build your competence, confidence, and capability in law school. Start today by hitting the subscribe button below. New episodes are posted every Friday. I've started using the ABCDE method of goal setting and goal getting for about 4 years now, and it's really helped me be organized and stay organized. I've mentioned this in our previous episodes, but all success has to start somewhere. Mine is my mission to build the six-story free legal aid clinic. The ABCDE method is a system of organizing and accomplishing our daily tasks. The system is based on the observations made by Vilfredo Pareto in 1895. Vilfredo Pareto was an Italian economist who made the observation that society naturally divides itself into 80-20. This means that the vital few, or 20% of the population, effectively controls 80% of the wealth, power, property, and influence. The other half, the 80% of the population, or the trivial many, controls about 20% of the wealth. The 80-20 rule is also applicable for law school. About 80% of the things you have to learn for a particular subject can be learned from 20% of the materials. Kung alam mo kung saan ang 20%, buhay ka na sa subject na yan, kapatid. For example, Criminal Law 1, 80% of the questions in your exams will come from 20% of the reading materials. That 20% can be learned from the justifying, exempting, mitigating, and aggravating circumstances under the revised penal code. Heto rin ang dahilan kung bakit walang nakakalampas ng Criminal Law 1 na hindi natututunan ng GEMA. The rest of what is expected of you will come from 80% of the other topics: definition ng felony, criminal liability, impossible crimes, and penalties. Another example for legal ethics: about 80% of the questions in the exams and recitations will come from about 20% of the materials. That 20% will come from the lawyer's oath plus the definition of the practice of law. Sa ulado mo ang dalawa, kapatid, ay wala ka nang ikakabagsak sa legal ethics. Heto ang dahilan bakit isa-isa tayong pinatatayo at pinaparecite ng lawyer's oath. It contains all of the principles you will need to answer some, most, or all of the questions in legal ethics. Ganyan din ang ABCDE method ni Brian Tracy. Naniniwala kasi siya na 80% ng kailangan nating matapos sa maghapon ay nakasalalay lang sa 20% ng ating mga activities. 80% of our success comes from achieving about 20% of our goals. The rest is busy work. Further, 80% of our tasks only accounts for about 20% of our results. Brian Tracy defines A goals as our most important goals. These are the goals that the accomplishment of which amounts to about 80% of our results. These are things that we must accomplish. Kung hindi natin na-accomplish, aba, finish na, kapatid. A, goals are tasks that have to be accomplished. If we fail, there will be serious consequences. It is entirely possible to have more than one A goal on your list. When that happens, you have to label them as A1, A2, A3, and so on. Halimbawa, dito ay ang ating paghahanda para sa klase gabi-gabi. A1 ang paggawa ng notes, A2 ang pagbabasa ng mga notes na yan. I've made a more detailed guide on how to finish your reading assignments, and I'll be leaving a link to that in the description below. B, goals are items that you should do, but failing to do them only has a minor consequence. Hindi hihinto ang mundo kung bukas mo na ito magagawa. Maaaring may mga taong maiinis, maiinip, o maaabala kung late mo na ito magagawa. Simplihan na lang natin, kapatid, huwag na huwag kang magsisimula ng B task kung meron ka pang A task sa listahan. A goals always come before B tasks. B tasks kung itinuturing ang pagre-record ko ng mga notes, ang pagsusulat ng mga case digests na babaunin ko sa klase mamaya. B task din ang karamihan ng mga emails na nakukuha ko sa trabaho. At some point kasi bilang empleyado, makakaranas ka ng dinadagsakan ng mga email. Email tungkol sa email, at magkakaroon kayo ng mga meeting tungkol sa mga meeting. These are B tasks that can be postponed until you finish all of your A goals. C tasks are tasks that do not have consequences. These are things that are nice to do, but if you don't do them, they have no bearing. C tasks sa ating mga nasa law school, ang lunch out kasama ang high school friends, ang catch-up dinner ng college barkada. C tasks din para sa akin ang mabilisang Batangas na ipinangako ko kay Chucky, ang aming alagang aso noong summer. Tuwang-tuwa kasi siya na naglulupasay sa buhangin at nagngangat-ngat ng bulalo sa biyahe namin pauwi. Oo, hindi pa nauulit, pero hindi rin naman siguro niya tanda na nangako ako sa kanya. D tasks are tasks that are easy to remember. D here stands for delegate. Ipasa, iasa, o ipasuyo sa iba. These are the tasks that you need to do but you do not have the time for them. For law students, marami tayo niyan. D tasks include tendering the payment for your rent, waiting for the receipt, paying your bills, at pipila ng matagal sa SM customer service. Pa-deposit ng mga dapat bayaran mula sa mga pinaglalagay mo na naman sa cart mo nung nakaraang 12-12, at pagbabalot ng regalo ngayong Pasko. E-tasks are tasks that you should eliminate altogether. Sa una lang naman, mahirap na alisin ang mga e-activities. These are things that take up your valuable time and attention but do not contribute to any of your success as a hardworking working law student. They are habits, activities, traditions which you have done in your younger years that made sense before you entered law school. E-tasks are not as important as you think. Here's a sample list of activities that I have to accomplish today. Let's take a look at all of them. I'll need you to pause this video and help me sort through my daily tasks. You can see the pattern developing here. Hanapin natin alin ang mga A tasks, B tasks, C tasks, and so on. As a hardworking working law student, my A tasks include 1. Be ready for a quiz in criminal law review. 2. Plan rank and file Christmas party. 3. Finalize venue for supervisor's Christmas party. These three activities account for 80% of what I have to accomplish for the day. They are written here in order A1, A2, A3. Kung magagawa ko ang tatlong to, okay na ako for the day. Una, syempre ang paghahanda sa klase sa criminal law review. Hindi naman mahigpit si judge sa klase. Discussion lang naman, pero babangon pa rin ako ng maaga dahil ayokong pumasok nang hindi ako nakaka-relate sa mga sinasabi niya. Hindi naman din ako nagbabayad ng mahal na matrikula para lang ma-OP sa klase. Planning the rank and file Christmas party is important kasi sila ang nambibitbit sa amin as a company. Kung so-so lang ang party, babagsak ang motivation nila. Mas madali silang piratahin ng mga competitors. For the same reason, kailangan ko ring unahin ang party ng mga visor. Vikings na lang ulit para hindi na mahirap isipin. The following items are now my B tasks. 1. Finish reviewer for commercial law review. 2. Upload Friday's episode for Lex in Motion. 3. Meet suppliers for Christmas basket. Hindi nagmamadali ang reviewer ko. Kung bukas ko pa to malulugaran, hindi naman malaking kabawasan. Mas mahalaga pa rin na makapagbasa ako sa criminal law review dahil pwede ko namang ipagpaliban ang editing ng notes ko. Sa parehong paraan, gawa na ang episode sa darating na Biyernes. Upload na lang naman gawa ng thumbnails, layout ng picture na ipopost ko sa Facebook at saka yung konting description. Mabilis lang gawin pero hindi naman dapat unahin. Bitas ko rin maituturing ang meeting with suppliers for Christmas basket. Simple lang ang direksyon sa akin, piliin ang pasok sa budget o ang pinakamurang proposal. Sa lahat ng quote na nasa desk ko, pasok naman lahat sa budget. Magkakatalo na lang sa mga freebies. Again, mas mahalaga sa akin na mapagplanuhan ang mismong party ng mga empleyado, ang menu at venue. The following items are my C tasks. 1. Call Globe to contest data charges. 2. Visit lumber supplier in Tanay. 3. Christmas dinner with old office mates. All of the activities on this list are not as important as people might make me think. Una, ang overbilling sa akin ng Globe ay 34 pesos lang naman. Kung tatawag ako sa customer service nila, mahaba-habang debate na naman to. Oo, prinsipyo lang ang inilalaban natin dito. However, priority ko pa rin na makapasok kay Judge mamaya na stress-free and ready to learn. Hindi ko na kailangan ng bad juju na dulot ng pakikipagtalo sa mga customer service representatives nila. Ang pagpunta sa lumber supplier ay hype lang din yan ng mga friends sa woodworking. Yes, mura ang kahoy, high quality at malaki ang potential profit. Pero sa Christmas season traffic natin, it does not seem to be worth my time. For the same reasons, I can always call and cancel on my friends from my old office. I'm very sure na may kasunod pa tong inuman near New Year kung saan pwede kaming magpaumaga sa kwento at alak. The following items are my D tasks. D, again, stands for delegate. Heto ang mga pwedeng ipasa, iasa at ipagawa sa sekretary ng office namin, sa mga messengers at helper sa bahay. 1. Deposit 2,500 for 12-12 purchases. 2. Prepare case digests for binding. 3. Pay credit card bill. Again, these tasks will occupy a large chunk of my time. Pwede namang unahin ko yung deposit ko para maaga din namang makarating yung binili ko. Pero, pasa na lang natin yan sa messenger or helper. Ganon din ang credit card bill dahil sa paghahanap pa lang ng parking, ubus na ang oras natin. Preparing case digests for binding is also an activity I can confidently delegate with our secretary. My handwritten case digests are more or less in the correct order. All she has to do is to match them up with our syllabus and to check if I missed a case. Again, this activity can take up an hour but it's a mechanical task. I'd rather come to class prepared than be happy with my digests kung next week pa naman ang pasahan. E is for eliminate. 1. Play Prison Architects Psych Ward Edition. It has been my tradition, our tradition sa family sa barkada na may tinatapos kaming game during the Christmas break. There was the year we finished Assassin's Creed 3, the expansion packs, Borderlands 2, and Call of Duty 1, 2, 3, and 4. All of these were great memories of my teens and 20s. But I'm going to be a dad in a few months. I'd rather spend my time designing and building my baby's crib, ang nursery niya, dresser at changing table. I guess this is what adulting is all about. But I am just a cartoon that appears every Friday. The best way to put the ABCDE method into practice is by making notes of all of your activities in a day. Isulat mo lahat ng mga pinaggagawa mo sa maghapon mo when you log your activities at makikita mong 4 na oras ka na palang naghahabol ng last star mo. Bago ka maging mythic, mapapaisip ka kapatid kung may direction ba ang buhay mo. Once you see how well you're wasting your time, you'll start to make more responsible choices towards the accomplishment of your own goals. I hope you've learned something from me today. Thank you so much for watching. Like and share this video for good law school karma and I will see you next Friday.